Hello. Today I'll be talking about the sports betting operator known as DraftKings, and more particularly talk about their stock, which is recently opened for public trading in April of 2020. So why exactly is DraftKings relevant to any of you? Well, considering we're in a business class, I figure many of you pay attention to the stock market, and some of you may even be interested in trading or already do so. Well, I believe DraftKings is a great stock to purchase for a long-term hold, and I'll talk about the many reasons why I feel confident in saying this. So first, what exactly is DraftKings? Well, DraftKings, like I said, is an American sports betting operator, which began in 2012. At the time, all they really had access to was called fantasy sports, which is daily games. More so, they fall under the gaming category than actual sports betting, so it's legal to partake in any state. However, just recently in 2019, they earned privilege to becoming themselves a sports book, which can only be legal in certain states. Their first operating post was in New Jersey, which showed great progress, which led them to expand to four other states, which include Pennsylvania, New Hampshire, Indiana, and West Virginia. And I will note, this is really relevant, because DraftKings is only open to 18% of the country population. So why is this relevant? Well, the stock opened in 2020 at $20 per trading. Now, today, in October, it sits at $53, an increase of over $33. And this is a huge spike for a company just recently released. It's still in its infancy stage, as many stock experts will say. Even in particular, the stock jumped to 65 at one point, falling recently due to coronavirus spikes in the NFL. So I'm going to take you through some contributions that are showing direct progress with the stock and why I think it continued to grow. Well, first, the return of sports. The stock really took off when we saw the return of the NBA and NHL in the form of bubbles in which they self-isolated to prevent coronavirus. Even more recently, baseball and the NFL have returned. And while those are the two biggest benefactors of DraftKings, we've seen the stock fluctuate so much because they're not in a secure environment. Recently, we've seen problems with the NFL where games are constantly being postponed and rescheduled. This directly conflicts their stock because people are directly investing in these games, and once they're canceled, it takes a hit to DraftKings' potential earnings. So, what else is relevant besides just the return of sports? Deals with professional sports franchises and even professional athletes. For example, Michael Jordan was just signed by DraftKings as an investor and even found himself with a direct seat on the advisory board. So you might ask, why is this relevant? Well, Michael Jordan is also the owner of the Charlotte Hornets, who are one of the NBA teams. This is relevant because that makes him the official partner of an owner, so they have direct control and influence over the company. To piggyback off that note, teams like the Philadelphia Eagles, New York Giants, and New England Patriots in the NFL, and including the Chicago Cubs and the MLB, have all partnered with DraftKings, which makes them the official stat provider for all these teams. What this really means is any pregame, postgame, and even during the game, all stats are provided by the company, which gives them recognition, and all trading is done through them. They also have a deal with ESPN, so they're constantly talked about there. Also, like I mentioned earlier, only 18% of the country has access to DraftKings. And there's thoughts that California can recently expand into that. California holds 12% of the country just within their state borders, which would rise DraftKings' total exposure to 30%. People believe that could bring the stock over $100 trading. That would be a huge jump to where it sits at 53 now. So this is just one of the areas for potential growth that the stock has. Not only once the virus is passed, will it continue to climb because there won't be worries about games being canceled, but also when states continue to legalize sports gambling. Because if you follow the trend of where the country is going, the real entertainment now is in the betting more so than the game. These players aren't viewed as for their fandom anymore, but instead as an asset to bettors to earn quick cash. Also, one analyst recently said that he believes DraftKings will become the Nike of clothing lines. So hence to say, DraftKings will become the top of the line sports betting and will have family recognition name. That is all, and I hope you all find DraftKings a very useful stock. Thank you.